All right, try it again. The prop stayed on until I hit the ground and the one flew off, but I've never had any of these little drones do this. It's weird. Shouldn't have to put any frickin' glue or nothing. They're meant to push on and pull off. Here we go. Crashing, just bumped the trees a little. All four props stayed on that time. Still doesn't seem right for me to come off that easy. But who am I? I'm just a little peon. Alright, this is a 2-cell battery. So less juice, not as much power. And almost the same, 500 milliamp compared to 525 on the last 3-cell battery. So let's see how this thing flies. Might fly a little easier, maybe a little smoother.
Damn it. Too much. Oh, what are the odds on the props being on here? Come on. Oh, wow, I got a freaking weed wound up in one of the motors, one of the palm frond little gizmos that fall off when they're dead. Come on out, little guy. All right, still got all my props. Problem with that one was I came in hot, and this 2-cell battery doesn't have enough ass to lift this drone. Is heavier than the cinebee HD. It was easier to fly a smooth, but when I needed some power to kick it up and not crash, it didn't have enough. I had it full throttle and it wouldn't lift. So anyway, still learning. Fun. At least it doesn't say land now anymore. And that's 2 flights without losing a prop. So this is a picture of the little guy with the voltage checker wired in, where you see number 3 there. When I get down to about 7.7 total volts, that will start chirping pretty loud. It's hard to hear in the video, but I could hear it. That means land. All right. So I've got my voltage tester connected to the one cable on the battery, and the battery plugged into the drone. So when I get to 7.8 or 7 point something, that actually worked. That's the voltage tester telling me when I get down to my lower limits.